Hi there, it's Dr. Elena Maganto here. Welcome to the Q&A series. Every week I'm gonna be answering the questions that you send me through Facebook, Instagram, or even YouTube. So here today we are gonna answer a very, very important question. So the question is, what are your thoughts on genetic testing for the purpose of prescribing a medication? And this is a very, very important question for two reasons: to understand what is genetic testing, and the other reason is not necessarily has to be to prescribe medication. So let's understand first what is a genetic testing. So the DNA is the material, the genetic material in our body that carries the information to describe whoever we are, who we look like outside, inside, and all the functionalities in our body. Then we have the genes that are areas in our DNA that are gonna be translated into proteins, and they are the ones describing the functionality in tissues, organs, and in general in all our body. So genetic testing is a medical testing where the practitioner is gonna take a sample, like for example, a blood work, and is gonna take it to the lab and read all your genome. And is gonna see if there is any specific change compared to whatever is expected. That is a genomic testing. So if there is a change compared to whatever is supposed to be expected, that would explain if you have any symptoms, any disorder, or if you are predisposed for a certain type of disease. Like for example, cancer, like if in your family there is family history of cancer, maybe in your genetic test you are gonna have the gene that predisposes you for breast cancer or ovary cancer. Also depressions, addictions, even cardiovascular diseases, diabetes is something that we can see in a genetic test. A lot of people, after they read the genetic testing, they get a little bit shocked, or the family members, and it's why usually in all these facilities, together with the genetic testing, there is a genetic testing counselor to talk to the person. But what I'm here today to tell you is that we don't have to be scared of the results of those testing, and here is why. So one of the things that the genetic testing can tell you is if you have a predisposition, as I said, for certain disease. Also, if you do carry a mutation in any of your genes, for example, a very common mutation that affects a large percentage of the population is the MTHFR mutation. The MTHFR is a gene that is gonna be translated in a protein in an enzyme with the same name. And that enzyme is important for breaking down homocysteine. Whenever there is a mutation in there, it's not able to break it down. So the levels of the homocysteine are higher, and also there is an impaired capacity to methylate. So what is this translated on? It's translated in a less capacity to produce glutathione, which is extremely important for detoxification, also for producing certain vitamins like methylated B12 is also very important, increases the risk of leaky gut, autoimmune conditions, heavy metals contamination because you are not able to detoxify it, coronary heart diseases. A lot of things have been related to the MTHFR mutation. But then besides diseases, there are also certain genes that, depending if they are on or off, we are more prone for a certain condition, for example, obesity. So do you know that there are 40 to 49 abdominal fat genes? Yes, 40 to 49 abdominal fat genes. So actually now there is some research that shows that the gene FTO and IRX3 are linked whenever they are on are linked for obesity or being overweight. So that is something that also we could see in a genetic testing. Also, the genetic testing can also tell you how well you are absorbing, metabolizing food, and how well you absorb certain nutrients, because during the screening, they are gonna see in certain areas of your genes, there are some genes variants that are gonna tell you if you are better for a high carbohydrate diet or lower carbohydrate diet, or higher in protein, lower in protein, low sodium. So all of that can come in a genetic testing as well. And there is actually a really good kit. I'm gonna put the link in the comments from Gino Palette, where they can test your capacity to absorb and metabolize certain foods. So that would be bio-individualized for your genes. So then as soon as you have the genetic testing, so what can we do with it? So first, don't get alarmed, as I said, based on your result. If you do have a mutation like the MTHFR mutation, there's no way to revert the mutation, but we can ameliorate the symptoms. So if you do have impaired capacity to have good levels of B12, we have to supplement with B12, we can supplement with glutathione to increase the capacity to detoxify. Also increase the capacity to detoxify doing certain detoxification tool protocol. There is always a way to ameliorate the symptoms, so there's no need to get alarmed about that. Now, those genes that I was talking about that can be switched on and off, we are able to control that. And that is the field of epigenetics. Epigenetics is a boom right now in science. There are a lot of studies, a lot of research, where they show that we are able to control the expression of our genes. Yes, we are able with the epigenetics. So what is the epigenetics? So imagine that our genes that have all the information, our DNA, is like a list of songs in a CD. And then we have the epigenome, the epigenetics, which is the DVD player, right? So the DVD player is the one that is gonna decide which song is gonna be selected. In this case, which is the gene that is gonna be expressed or not. So usually the expression is with methylation and histones. So those are the ones that put the mechanism and the instructions in there for switching on or switching off the genes. So I love a book. I do really recommend a book that is called Change Your Genes, Change Your Life, where have put together a lot of the scientific research where it says that our genes respond to everything that we do. Everything that we do in our lifestyle. What do we eat? What do we drink? All the environmental toxins that we are surrounded with. How we are able to handle stress. All those emotional toxins that we all put in our body. So that is also conditioning that certain genes are switching on and off. Can you imagine how powerful is this? Because what this is describing is that we are able, with this genetic testing and biomarkers, we are able to establish a lifestyle protocol for the person that has a mutation or any genes that are on and have to be off, or the opposite. So this is really, really important scientific working on progress, I would say, because we are able to control our genes. And some examples for that is the genes that I was talking about before that control obesity, like for example FTO or IRX3, if they are on, it's possible to switch off those genes, like with things like, for example, managing stress, avoiding any BPA. BPA is a really dangerous toxin that we find on plastic and cans. Like, store all your food in containers that are not plastic, so you prevent BPA. BPA is one of the most important toxins to avoid because it's an endocrine system disruptor. Also, you take foods like turmeric or green tea that also helps in switching off those genes. Cancer, for example. There are a lot of things that we could do for that. Like, for example, changes in our diet. It's important to control carbohydrates and sugars because cancer cells grow with sugar. They have receptors in the membrane for sugar. Also, exercising, managing stress, the release of cortisol affects also cancer. So it's why we can control the expression of our genes and establish a lifestyle protocol for that based on our genetic testing. So how powerful is that? I hope this have answered your question.